Hello friends, welcome to Mastering VMware. My name is Mayur Parmar and in this video I will show you how you can easily install the vCenter Server 6 in the Windows Server 2012 R2. So before begin with installation, we will first require the vCenter Server 6 ISO, which you can easily download from the vmware.com website. But for downloading the ISO, you will require the VMware account. So if you don't have account, so first register to vmware.com and then you can easily download the vCenter Server 6 ISO. The ISO size is around 2.5 GB, so it will take time according to your speed. But we already have downloaded the ISO, so we will directly begin with the installation process. So after downloading the ISO, just mount the ISO to CD/DVD drive. And here you can find the autorun.exe. So just double click on autorun.exe to start the installer. And now installer is started. So just choose the vCenter server for Windows. It is already selected and click install button. And now here we are getting some kind of warning. So just ignore it, click OK. And now the vCenter server installer wizard has started. So just click next to proceed further. And now we are getting the end user license agreement. So just click on I accept the license agreement, click next. And here we have to specify the deployment type. In vCenter Server 6, we have two types of deployments available. First is the embedded deployment. In embedded deployment, vCenter Server and the Platform Service Controller are deployed in the same server. But if you are going with the external deployment, you can either install the Platform Service Controller or you can install vCenter Server. But if you are only installing the vCenter server, previously installed Platform Service Controller is required. But in our scenario, we don't have any Platform Service Controller installed. So we will be going with the embedded deployment. So just choose the vCenter server and embedded Platform Service Controller and click on next. And now we have to provide the system name. System name is used to connect the vCenter server. So in system name, you can provide either the host name or you can provide the IP address. You can provide the host name if you have DNS setup in your environment. But we don't have any kind of DNS setup, so we are just going with the IP address. So just put the IP address and click on next. And here you might get a warning regarding the host name, which is FQDN. We only provided the IP address, so we are getting this warning. So just ignore it, click OK. And here we have to configure the vCenter single sign-on. vCenter single sign-on is used in the vCenter to authenticate the multiple VMware vSphere solution products. So here we have two options. You can either create new vCenter single sign-on or you can join the existing one. If you already have the single sign-on domain, you can join the vCenter single sign-on domain by providing the Platform Service Controller IP, the port number, the administrator user which is embedded, and the password of the administrator user. But we don't have any existing single sign-on domain, so we will create our new domain. And here the domain name is already mentioned, which is vSphere.local, and we are going with the default. And the username is already mentioned here, administrator. We can't change it, so we have to provide the administrator password. So just choose the password, which is alphanumeric. And here we have to provide the site name. Site name you can choose any, but we are going with the default. And make sure that you provide all the details are correct, because vCenter single sign-on configuration cannot be changed after deployment. So click on next. And here we have to provide the service account for the vCenter server instance to run. And here we have two options. You can either use the Windows system local account, or you can specify the different service account you have created for vCenter. But we don't have any specific user account, so we are going with the Windows local system account. So just choose the local account, click next. And here we have to provide the database for the vCenter server. Database in the vCenter server are more useful because all your virtual inventory database are stored in the database in the backend. you can use the two types of database in the vCenter 6. You can either use the MS SQL Server to MS SQL Server, which is Microsoft SQL Server, or you can use the Oracle Database Server. In the MS SQL Server, you can either use the 2008 R2, 2012, 2014. Or if you are going with the Oracle Database Server, you can either use the Oracle 11G and 12C. But if you are going with the external database, you will have to create the ODBC DSN name first, which will be listed here automatically if you have created ODBC DSN. But we are going with the embedded database because we don't have external database any right now. But if you want to see any external database connectivity and how to create ODBC DSN, the links are mentioned in the description below. So we are going with the embedded database. So just choose the embedded Postgres database and click on next. Now here we have to configure the ports. Ports are used in the vCenter for the connectivity of ESXi host and other networking connectivity. So make sure that you check all the ports are free in your network environment. And if they are not free, you can also modify the ports here. But best practice says that you go with the default ports only. So just check all the ports availability and click next. And here we have to provide the destination directory for the vCenter server installation and to store its data. You can either go with default, which is the system drive C drive, or you can change it. But we are going with the default, so just click on next. And now here we are ready to install the vCenter server 6. So just review all your configuration you have done before proceed with installation and click install button to start the installation process. And installation can take around 25 to 30 minutes depending on your configuration. So till that time I am pausing the video and I will resume the video when the installation gets completed. So guys, now you can see that we have successfully installed the vCenter server 6. So now you can either launch the vSphere web client or just click on finish to close the installer. So guys, thank you for watching the video. You can check out more step-by-step articles on our website, which is masteringvmware.com. The link is also available below in the description. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please subscribe. And if you like the video, please like and share the video. And thank you for watching again, guys.